Let me, in 2 minutes, introduce you into the issue, because I myself run, what you can see here, an observatory on intolerance and discrimination against Christians in Europe. And normally when I say in Europe, I get puzzled looks. People say, what are you talking about, right? But the name of the observatory also already reflects the problems we are having and why we are also having this panel. The website you see here looks like this. We have an advanced search where you can now find specific cases, 700 individual cases, that is 700 personal stories of intolerance against Christians in Europe, and it's 700 stories too many. Christians, and this is the broad background on the issue, face social hostility and marginalization. We have, for example, the following number. There are, unfortunately, not many numbers around yet. Governments are not collecting them. But 84% of vandalism in France in 2010 was directed against Christian sites. This is a most striking number. If you hear vandalism, everybody thinks of anti-Semitism. Well, in many countries, the number is much higher when it targets Christians. The same here in the United Kingdom, 48% of all clergy had said themselves that they had suffered some kind of violence in the past 12 months in the United Kingdom. The same with regard to how people feel they're being treated. More than 60% of UK Christians say they feel more sidelined than ever. And 71% of United Kingdom Christians say that they perceive an increase in the marginalization of Christians in the media. I think these numbers, they are from the UK. We don't have numbers of other countries, but they might be of, in some respect similar, and they are definitely striking. Now, that's the social issues, but now we move into the legal area. We detect problems in the following areas: freedom of religion, collective and individual, freedom of conscience, and other panels talk about the problem. Parental rights, and I don't need to mention the Spanish issues you have there, freedom of assembly, and then, and here we come to today, discriminatory equality policies is what we will talk about here, and also freedom of expression. And to finish, the OSCE, the Organization for Security and Cooperation in Europe, 56 member states, including the United States, for those of you are interested, has adopted a resolution just a year ago, in July 2011, where they say, we have a problem in Europe and all the OSCE countries with the way how Christians are being treated. And they say in this resolution, unanimously adopted, that we need a public debate on the rights of Christians to participate fully in public life. They say that we need an assessment of legislation in the OSCE states, and that's what our panel is about today. And that the OSCE encourages the media not to spread prejudices against Christians and to combat negative stereotyping. I think such a resolution, unanimously adopted by OSCE 56 member states, is alarming. And it's just about time to talk about these issues, and that's why I'm so grateful to the organizers to have this panel today, and I'm very happy.